Good morning and thank you all for being here. For my dissertation, I'm doing a diachronic study of mobility in a rural municipality, which its name is Cuntis, in the province of Pontevedra, Galicia, northwest of the Iberian Peninsula. As an example, we will use an area of approximately 8 square kilometers, very small, which corresponds to the parish of Estacas and the parish of Pinheiro, since their nuclei are located in the same valley. One of our questions for this dissertation are if the traditional roads between those nuclei correspond to examples of least cost paths. These are preliminary results. The work is still in progress. Yes, like I said right now. When we are conducting a study on such a small area, a digital model with a resolution of 10 meters per cell or more, you are avoiding most of the interferences caused by anthropogenic alterations. But unfortunately, we lose accuracy if we compare optimal paths with the remains of ancient and/or traditional paths we have registered. Instead, we can take advantage of the possibilities offered by the aerial laser scanner, creating high-resolution models. In our case, we generate two models of 1 and 5 meters per cell, the first for remote sensing and the second one for calculations, because it reduces the calculation time and, from our own experience, it's an acceptable resolution for the check-ins. The model of 1 meter, as you can see, all the alterations are from the agrarian roads, mostly in this image. With the model of the 5 meters, we erase a good part of those elements that may condition the mobility, such as the barriers, like buildings and walls and so on, and those that favor the mobility, like roads and highways and so on. But still, those wider roads or buildings don't disappear completely. It's for that reason that it's necessary to make that topographic restitution. Well, this is the same model of 5 meters, but applying the topographic restitution. As we can see, the digital model of 1 meter represents all of kind of anthropological alterations on the landscape. Most of them are the result of the past 50 years of modernization. By applying the topographic restitution, we can generate digital terrain models similar to the previous topography that are, at least, based on those data or information at our disposal, which help us to make corrections. In order to do it, the first step is to identify what are the elements that we must erase from the point clouds and register them with lines or polygons. To identify them, we use shaded relief models such as hillshade, slope models, or orthophotos, current and historical, especially the 1956 and 57 series known as Vuelo Americano B or American Flight B. As an example, well, here are the same area with different models and different orthophotos, where all the difference between them you can see. As an example, we can see using the four images how the landscape has changed in recent decades. Thus, we can determine which elements are more recent or modern and which we should erase or maintain on digital terrain models. For this case, it has only been necessary to remove roads and paths. And furthermore, while we identify them, we were able to do a typological classification. We set four types for this area: the main roads, the rural roads between the nuclei, the farming roads, which the older have about 25 years, and the forest roads. This classification will allow us in the future to know where there is a current path over an ancient one and compare them with the optimal paths. Once we have selected all roads, we proceed to save the point cloud as a new file, but certain points are subtracted when applying our polygon and mask as masks, as we can see on the next image. This is the point cloud, but without the points corresponding to the ground points of all the roads and paths. Now we can see the differences between the two models with the same resolution, but the second one with the topographic restitution. We can see certain evidences about the roads on the left one, but at the right side there's no evidences. Does it work? Now it's time to check if the resolution is effective and brings different results in our calculations. For that, we calculate the same route from the model with and without restitution, with Tobler and ArcMap algorithms. Also, we can compare the optimal paths with the polylines and buffers we did to erase the points from the LiDAR. Before finishing the calculation, watching the backlinks obtained, we can see certain differences among them. The left one, without restitution, we can see certain marks of the current roads, while with the right one, all the backlinks are more natural. Here the maps are the same area but divided. The left image is the upper part and the right part is the lower part. Now that we have calculated the optimal paths, we load them on the same layer. The colors black and green at the legend were calculated without topographic restitution, with the result that both follow the same way. That is the reason why we only see the black one. Instead, the blue and yellow colors correspond to computations with topographical restitution. Another example, without restitution, yellow and red follow the same route, while green and pink follow different routes. Here we can see the different routes over the buffers we did, representing the roads we erased from the model. Without the restitution, most part of the like the black one or the yellow tend to follow the buffers of the current roads, while the others search for the optimal path avoiding these current roads. In conclusion, LiDAR point clouds might be very useful for archaeological studies beyond the typical remote sensing of archaeological evidence. Thus, we can represent previous landscapes, but it's necessary to make corrections. In the case of local mobility studies, restitution is necessary because if we do not make it, it's possible to get wrong conclusions. I gladly accept all your appreciations. Thank you.